Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Wednesday Night Prayer Meeting, a podcast about the history of jazz told from the perspective of someone who's been piecing it together one record at a time over the course of 20-odd years digging through record bins. From Hermosa Beach, California, I'm your host, Frank, and that was Candy's Ride from the soundtrack to the film Sweet Love Bitter, composed and performed by Mal Waldron, with Waldron on piano, George Coleman on tenor, George DeVivier on bass, and Al Dreeres on drums. I have a soft spot for soundtrack music performed and composed by jazz musicians, as it allows for unusual forms to be laid out, and Candy's Ride is a brilliant example of what I mean, with Dreeres's machine gun snare hits and Waldron's terse left-hand chord stabs making for an exciting minute or so of music. I haven't been able to find a copy of the full film, which is loosely based on the late career of Charlie Parker, but there is an interesting collection of clips from it on YouTube, including one wherein the protagonist discusses some jazz theory with some uptight university professors before getting them giggling and passed out on the floor stoned. It's definitely worth a few minutes of your time to check it out, and I will link it in the show notes. This week's episode is about the music of Mal Waldron, a pianist whose career spanned 5 decades and who played with virtually all of jazz's biggest stars. Waldron was born in 1925 in New York City and began taking piano lessons at age 5. He drew inspiration from some of the milestone jazz performances. First, he was inspired to play the saxophone after hearing Coleman Hawkins' seminal solo on Body and Soul. Unable to afford a tenor, Waldron picked up the alto sax and played it in various settings, but ultimately switched over to the piano, partly after hearing the groundbreaking alto work by Charlie Parker and feeling as though he couldn't live up to what the Yardbird was doing on the horn. It turned out to be a fruitful changeover. Waldron started playing jazz in New York in the 50s, and by the end of the decade was the house pianist for the Prestige record label, recording dozens of albums as a sideman and leader. This first song is called Warm Canto, from one of Waldron's dates as a leader, and he's joined by Eric Dolphy on the clarinet. Enjoy. Thank you.
Cheers, guys. Thank you.
That was Tension from the album Mal 3 Sounds by Mal Waldron, with Waldron on piano, Art Farmer on trumpet, Eric Dixon on flute, Kalo Scott on cello, Julian Yule on bass, and Elvin Jones on drums. Before that was Jump Monk from the album Mingus at the Bohemia by Charles Mingus, with Mingus on bass, George Merrow on tenor, Eddie Burt on trombone, Mal Waldron on piano, and Willie Jones on drums. And starting that set off was Warm Canto from the album The Quest by Mal Waldron, with Eric Dolphy on clarinet, Waldron on piano, Ron Carter playing cello, John Benjamin on bass, and Charlie Persip on drums. Up next is a tune from a Max Roach album that Mal Waldron appeared on. The song's called Another Valley. Enjoy.
Oh,
That was C'est Formidable from the album Impressions by Mal Waldron, a trio record with Waldron on piano, Addison Farmer on bass, and Albert Heath on drums. Before that was Chaz Jazz from the album One Entrance, Many Exits, with Waldron on piano and David Friesen on bass. And starting that set off was Another Valley from the album It's Time by Max Roach, with Roach on drums, Richard Williams on trumpet, Julian Priester on trombone, Clifford Jordan on tenor, Mal Waldron on piano, and Art Davis on bass. One of the associations that left a lasting mark on Waldron's career was the time he spent playing piano for Billie Holiday. Waldron was her pianist from 1957 until her death in 1959. The two formed a strong bond in their time together, and Waldron revisited her music in various settings throughout his later career. Up next is a track from Billie's performance at the 1957 Newport Jazz Festival that features Mal Waldron, Willow Weep for Me. Enjoy.
Willow, weep for me. Willow, weep for me. Bend your branches down along the ground and cover me. Listen to my plea. Hear me, willow, and weep for me. Gone my lovely dreams, lovely summer dreams. Gone and left me here to weep my tears along the stream. Sad as I can be, hear me, willow, and weep for me. Whisper to the wind, and say that love has sinned to leave my heart a-sighing and crying alone. Murmur to the night, hide its starry light, so none will find me sighing, crying all alone. Weeping willow tree, weep in sympathy. Bend your branches down along the ground and cover me. Listen to my plea. Hear me, willow, and weep for me. Willow. Willow, we
That was Lady Sings the Blues, one of Lady Day's signature songs, performed as a duet from the album Left Alone Revisited, with Mal Waldron on piano and Archie Shepp on tenor. And before that was Willow Weep for Me from Billie Holiday's performance at the 1957 Newport Jazz Festival, with Holiday singing, Mal Waldron on piano, Joe Benjamin on bass, and Joe Jones on drums. Usually on this program, I end the show with a long piece of music, and decided that on this episode I'd like to play two longer pieces because they both struck me as worth hearing, and they illustrate two extremes of Waldron's playing, one tending towards the abstract and avant-garde, and the other that is pretty straightforward bebop. Up first is the more abstract one, Spacewalk. Enjoy.
Thank you.
That was Spacewalk from the album Up Pop the Devil, with Mal Waldron on piano, Carla Poole on flute, Reggie Workman on bass, and Billy Higgins on drums. Thanks so much for listening. I'll have some more Mal Waldron coming up in future episodes, and there were some aspects of his biography that I didn't want to dwell on too much here, as I plan on addressing them in future episodes, so keep listening in the coming weeks. If you have any questions or comments or requests, please feel free to call the Wednesday Night Prayer Meeting voicemail box at 424-704-1666 or email wnpmpod@gmail.com. The second long piece for tonight is probably Waldron's most famous tune of the estimated 400 that he composed. It was written for John Coltrane and first appeared on an album by the Prestige All-Stars called Interplay for Two Trumpets and Two Tenors. With John Coltrane and Bobby Jaspar as the two tenors, Idris Suliman and Webster Young playing the trumpets, Mal Waldron on the piano, Kenny Burrell on guitar, Mr. PC Paul Chambers on bass, and Art Taylor on the drums. This is Soul Eyes. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.